Hey everybody, welcome to the Marvel Hero Stream. I'm Ryan Collins Rielnir, and this is my friend, Gif Code. We're here today. We're not going to be showing off team-ups. We're going to be showing off Doctor Strange. We're going to have a special guest. We're going to be talking about this weekend's awesome promotions and playing Doctor Strange. I'm going to be leveling Doctor Strange from level 1, having a good time, keeping it casual. And I'm playing on the live server today on my Rielnir account. So if you guys want to jump into Marvel Heroes, you can find me. I'm currently in Avengers Tower. We're going to actually switch over to that already. And I'm going to be talking to you guys in the chat. I'm going to be answering questions. Going to be kicking bad guy butt. And pretty excited, actually. It's going to be a fun one. Sorry about no team-ups. Everybody's very sad about that. We're going to have team-ups. We're scheduling one for mid to early next week so that we can show everything. We want to show you guys Falcon, Firestar, Magic, and the person that I'm actually super excited for, Spider-Man, of course. We're going to be showing off their UI. We're going to show how they work. We're hoping to get the live stream in before we get to the pre-sale ends so that you guys can have a chance to check out how they work and everything. So if you guys have any questions during the stream about team-ups, I can hopefully answer them today just pretty casually as we're going along. Like I said, we're going to have a special guest later. But let's start by playing some Marvel Heroes. Somebody asked for. We're gonna skip the entrance. I don't want to spoil anything. You don't need to see Uatu's fate. I'm sure you guys have seen it many times before. I'm getting party invitations like crazy, and I'm sorry, guys. I'm going to play the opening first, and then I'll join your party. And maybe I might be doing some Midtown today. Is the good doctor here? I'm gonna be doing maybe some Holosim if we get high enough level. Somebody asked, Shadow Cat as a team-up, you guys say. That would be super interesting, wouldn't it? That is actually one that I would love to see almost more than any team-up. So Doctor Strange, as you guys know, came out today. The Sorcerer Supreme himself with the Bolts of Balthazar. He got the Fangs of Farala. He's got Teleportation, the Crimson Bands of Sidorak. He is crazy awesome in our game. He is so much fun to play. I am so excited to start him on my live account. This is my dev account. So if you guys want to see me in game, you can see me running around as Rielnir today, not as my super secret name that I don't tell people because I like to play with you guys without you knowing who I am. It's fun that way. I actually play with so many people from our community and so many and posters and our forums and from these streams, and you guys don't even know it, and it's kind of great. So we're going to be playing Doc Strange today. I might show off Shuri. That we have a brand new enhanced costume, which is the Black Panther's sister, Shuri, and she is pretty great. The new claws for Black Panther. He got his level 52 today. Really shows that off, how cool she is. She looks great with the claws. I'm a big fan. I'm working on a heavy claws with throwing daggers build. What are my favorite VFX in the game? My favorite VFX in the game used to be the good Johnny Blaze, but I think I've moved to really loving Doc Strange, actually. Doctor Strange, like the way we've done his spells straight out of the Book of the Vashanti, he has some of the craziest stuff, and I don't know, just everything. We're not going to get to see any of his too high level stuff today, and I'm playing kind of like scrub right now because I'm talking. But his VFX get insane. Even his basic attack is one of the coolest basics in the game. Let's see what we got. We're going to save some citizens today, no reason to leave them behind. And they're a great source of XP in the early game to get me up to level 5 as soon as possible, which is when stuff starts to get really fun. I'm going to try to spend as little time putting points into powers and stuff, so I've kind of already planned out where I want to go with him. So, how are you guys doing today? How are you guys liking Doctor Strange and everything that came with the new patch, including the new size inventory, which is huge, even though it's two more lines for completely free, as you guys know. And, man, it helps. I was playing on the live server for just a little bit earlier, and I was doing an X defense run. It's like, man, I'm not out of space yet. What's the deal? So, if you guys don't know, I have it in my in my window here, we're doing a today. If you check your email, you should have one if you already have a Marvel Heroes account. But we're doing a giveaway code that's in my lower third here. It's MHM Gift, which will give you a free 200 Splinter introductory heroes, what we're calling them. So they're the original five starter heroes: Thing, Hawkeye, Scarlet Witch, Storm, Daredevil, and also Black Widow's in that list because she's also at that price point. So if you put this code in, you'll get them, one of them, a token for them. Whether or not you already have them, it's completely random. And you'll also get a pretty awesome a range of boosts just to kind of get you playing today, get you help you level your new Doctor Strange. I'm not getting beat up, I would say. I'm just, you know, taking it a little slow trying to give you guys this info. So yeah, you guys can get that code today. You'll get free hero right off the bat. Just put it in. It's good for the weekend. I think it expires at the end of the weekend, but I'm not totally sure on the expiration date. But you can just go to marvelheroes.com and go to your profile page at the top, and I'm just going to burn down Black Cat here. You go to your profile page at the top, and you can I haven't put points in. This is totally a scrub move. And you can redeem code, and it'll work out for you. And you will get awesome stuff, and we can play together. And I'm going to go hang out in Avengers Tower in a bit as I'm answering questions so you guys can check out Doc Strange. I'll float around, do some awesome stuff. This is something I see all the time. Nobody realizes that if you highlight a power and press the key you want to put it on, it'll go straight there. It is a super-duper useful trick. I wouldn't say nobody realizes it. I just see people dragging all the time during streams. It makes me sad. It makes me sad that that very cool feature is not known. When are team ups live? People are asking. So if you guys aren't familiar, team ups are a new system we're adding very, 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 very soon. And they feature characters like Falcon, Spider-Man, Magic, and Spider-Man, the most important team-up of all, who was first featured in the first Marvel team-up ever. And so next week we're going to have these, and the way they work is that they're essentially a companion for your hero. They allow you to have somebody follow you around either at all times, come out for big special ultimate attacks, basically their version of ultimates, or you can have them never out, if you prefer. They come with 30 spaces of free inventory with them, and they have gear that you can equip. They have their own skills that you can pick and choose the skills you want. You can customize what kind of team up you really want that person to be. So you can have Firestar, who comes out and destroys everyone for 30 seconds and buffs your energy damage, for instance. You can have a more of a scrappy Firestar that hangs out with you and nukes enemies from afar, but sticks with you all the time. And you can decide, like, hey, I don't really want Firestar around me almost ever, but I do, you know, I want to get the benefits. And she will have passive effects that buff your abilities, and also a proc that will let her, like, rain hell on your enemies randomly, which is pretty great. And, like, the VFX on those are crazy. You can actually visually see her destroying your enemies. So the team up feature is coming next week. I'm pretty stoked for that. It's going to be a pretty interesting feature. I think it really changes the game. It really adds a new layer to the game. The gear is going to be pretty exciting. I'm really, really curious to see how people build their team ups. Like what do you spec magic for? Like, what kind of gear do you put on magic? They have their own kind of gear. You don't use normal hero gear. They have 4 item slots. And we'll have more about that. We're going to be streaming next week to show them off and show them in action. We're going to have Michael May, who's been designing them, talk about their powers. And we're going to hopefully be teasing maybe some future ones. We have some pretty crazy stuff coming along. I'm very, very excited for that feature. What team-ups do you guys want to see? I'm very curious. So what is the character that you want to see as a team-up? Who do you think would be a good fit? I saw a very good request earlier for Shadowcat, Kitty Pryde, of course. She's a wonderful character because she's not super offensive in nature. She is a martial artist, but her main power is that she phases, she goes through walls, and I'm a huge Kitty Pryde fan. But, you know, she as a playable character, it's kind of like, well, you can't really go through walls in an ARPG all the time. That's not very fair. Although some characters can teleport, so. but it's not a very compelling thing, right? Like, teleportation is inherently way better. So that is a fine example. Somebody said She-Hulk. That's another great example. It's important to know that just because they're team up doesn't mean they won't be playable. Like, there's no reason we can't do Firestar as a playable character someday. I'm pretty excited though. It lets us get characters in earlier than we otherwise would. Like, obviously Firestar isn't slated this year. If you guys are familiar with our advanced pack, we've already announced 10 of 12 heroes, and we have a lot more coming. And Firestar is unfortunately not on that list, but it doesn't mean she won't be in the future. But now this way she can be in the game. You can have Firestar at your side. Somebody asked for D-Man, Demolition Man. I love that guy. I would love to have him as a team up. He almost seems like a April Fool's playable character option. I think I teased that before as a joke. But I think that guy's great. Judge Dredd, not applicable, sadly. Valkyrie would be great from her Secret Avengers. She's just a good fit for our game in general. We do a lot of Asgard stuff. She has a lot of cool weapons. We could do the Secret Avengers. We could do the classic Champions version. I think she was on the Champions. She might actually have been a Defender. Everybody, Chuck Norris. We actually couldn't have Chuck Norris. He would be impossible to balance. It's like as strong as the Hulk, as accurate as Hawkeye, better than basically just anything ever. I'm not using my cooldowns properly. So the way Doctor Strange works is it's a new thing for some people. So Doctor Strange has a lot of cooldowns, and he has big powers, these incantations we call them, that have cooldowns, and they tick this bar on your screen. This is called mysticism. For every 5 mysticism points you get, your next incantation is free and resets your cooldown. It takes 10% off all your cooldowns. So the way to really play Doctor Strange that I'm not super exemplifying because I'm trying to re-chat, talk, and play is that you cast your cooldowns. So you have your big cooldowns incantations like Crimson Bands of Sidorak and Seven Sons of Cinnabis, and you use them to basically reset each other. So by the more you chain and get in a good row, the faster you can get to your next ones and start the rotation over again. And it is a really interesting flow. It's a very different gameplay for our game. Somebody's at my window right now, and I think we're going to get joined by a special guest, actually. We're gonna go to the big screen here.
What?
We're going to go to the big screen as the special guest comes and sits down next to me. And I'm going to delay as
Isn't
long as
special guest number 2 coming in, too?
Special guest number 2, does he want to sit behind us?
I'll come after.
He'll come after. I'm not going to tell you who that is, guys.
The big daddy.
Look at this.
The
I wore the guy. Appropriate shirt today,
Oh,
too.
Man, that's perfect. I didn't, actually.
Very lucky.
I'm wearing a band T-shirt. I feel very sad and embarrassed. This is David Brevik, it turns out. This guy.
What? Who? Where?
The Cow King himself. apparently, that's what I'm allowed to call him at work now. He doesn't know that until I just said it on a live stream to the entire world. David Brevik, welcome to our Marvel Heroes live stream. And Doomsaw is behind us, and he is creeping on us hard.
He's just
This is Doomsaw and David Brevik, and he's moving in slow motion. David, how are you doing today? Oh no, we're all in slow motion.
I'm doing well. How are you?
I'm doing very well. I'm
Wow.
I'm doing this thing where I'm having a hard time. I'm the usual.
The usual playing the game and talking at the same time.
And reading the stream. And also reading chat just to see if anybody's PMing me. And that's been a fun
Doesn't
learning
sound
experience.
Like really there's much to do there.
No. I'm an excellent multitasker. I feel that all nerds...
Actually, it's something that I have to do all the time. I'm giving presentations to different people. It's the exact same thing. And yesterday I was giving this presentation to this group, and I died in the middle of, like, demoing the game. They were asking me a question, and I was like, oh, well, if you look at it, and I look back, and oh, my God... Well, it shows I can't play my own game.
it's funny for me. Like there's this lingering thing because I don't know if you saw the live stream where I first showed off the Shield Holosim, but I died. Yeah. I was trying to read chat and I died. And I got it was
it's
I died. I died in the worst possible way. I got one-shotted, and I will never live that down. Like to this day, everybody still reminds me like, hey, Realner, remember that time you died on a live stream with 5,000 people watching? So
reminds me the you remember the Ultima Online when Lord British came in, played online, and they killed him.
Of course. Oh, really? I actually don't know that story. So he was just trying to hang out with them, and they're.
Yeah, no, he came in to play the game with the community, make this big announcement. It was like one of the very beginning of Ultima Online. This is, I don't know, 20 years ago now. Now I'm really aging myself.
I was in diapers. I was probably in diapers. I'm going to make you sad. I wouldn't be in diapers, but I'd be quite young 20 years ago.
No,
we're not going to talk about
that. I realize that.
We're going to talk about...
Meanwhile, I was already, you know, making my first company. So
well, you know... Not all of us can be super successful people who change the game industry.
No, I'm just,
like, hey.
I'm just saying I'm old. That's all I'm saying.
it's okay. Your creations seek to ruin my school career.
Well,
in high
thank
school.
You. I think.
No, that's a compliment. That means that I played.
It ruined you
too
all the way
much.
To working here.
See, that's the going back and. Pointing that out to my mother, it's like, look, Mom, it worked out.
Yeah, like, that's my dad, I went to college and got my degree in computer science, and I got out of school. I said, I'm going to make video games for a living. And this is, you know,
what?
Back when this was not a big industry.
Of course.
He's like, oh, my God, we just wasted all that money on college. What the hell have you done?
What have I done?
Yeah, exactly.
It worked out okay. It worked out okay. I get to hang out with these guys and make them watch me play a game while I spoil awesome stuff. We're getting lots of questions. Yeah, somebody just asked me in game, what does David think of Doctor Strange? And he is awesome.
He is awesome.
He turned out
really, really well.
Yeah, like
we're really happy with him.
As perfect as I could have imagined.
Yeah.
Like at first I remember the initial chats.
He's looking really great too.
Oh yeah, so good. At the initial chats, I was always like, oh, man, I'm so worried. Like, there's such a high expectation of Doctor Strange. Like, he's so big. Like, he's right. So, like, on a meta level and a visual level, he's so big. And I am so happy with how he turned out. I still have the habit of I click every quest guy because I come from every MMO ever.
I understand.
And even on this would be my 31st playthrough because it's my 31st, our 31st character. This is our 31st character.
Very nice. Do you play through all difficulties, or you just usually play through
I usually
normal?
Play through at least normal, and some characters I've played through every difficulty, especially closer to when we had difficulty modes first come out.
Right.
But I actually play, I've probably played through normal on every character now.
Can you be prestiged with anybody?
No, I'm thinking about prestiging Moon Knight. I have him at 60, but I like his gear so much right now that I feel sad to leave it behind.
But you're getting it back.
That's true. It's my new goal.
Temporary.
But then I can't play Doctor Strange because I'm focused on Moon Knight.
There's that.
So let's.
All right, let's answer some questions.
Let's answer some questions. What do we got going? Do you remember the Bard's Tale MMO?
Bard's Tale MMO?
Did Bard's Tale have an MMO?
I do not remember.
Would
Bard's
that be like
Tale
a
MMO.
MUD? Basically, oh, geez. So we, as you know, we have a gift today. We're giving out awesome stuff. Let's talk about this weekend.
We're giving out a whole bunch of
stuff. We're giving out a lot of
stuff.
This
weekend's a little bit crazy.
There are times where internally we're kind of like, is this too much? like our studio director was like, I'm having trouble to keep track of all the cool things we're doing this weekend. Will people not be confused? It's like, no, they'll be fine. they're going to love it, trust me. But let's talk about this weekend. So as you know, Mr. Doomsaw himself signed you up for a pretty big deal. We are having the More Cowbell Saturday.
I know.
Which is the greatest name for an event I think ever held by an MMO.
Yes, I am very excited about it.
If you guys don't know, Dave will be around tomorrow. Tomorrow is Saturday because that's how time works. And he will be playing with you guys, and we're going to be giving out a really awesome daily gift tomorrow that's just packed full of awesome stuff. A brand new rune word, right? Two portals, one to Bovenheim, one to the cow level.
Right.
So you can go kick Dave's cow butt. Don't actually, you know, it's not his real cow butt. that's here.
Whether or not I have a cow butt is not really discussed.
That's not discussed, yeah. I'm just saying he sits down for a reason in this stream. He doesn't stand. That's very weird. This conversation took a weird turn. Anyway, he's going to be playing with you guys for a couple hours. He's going to be chatting on his Xerix account. We have that all posted on the forums. We have I'll have a infographic on here later. To show you guys about it. I don't want to switch it right now because if I mess up, I will spoil the costume I'm going to reveal today. And I don't want to do that. That would be sad. All right. I'm going to reveal a very cool costume that I'm super excited for. Have you gotten to see Winter Soldier, Dave? Have you gotten to see it?
The movie?
Yeah, have you gotten to see it yet?
I can neither confirm nor deny.
He got to see it. I knew it. When you're Dave Brevik, you get special privileges. I am so excited for that film.
Rumor has it good one.
I hear it's one of the best Marvel films. And rumor has it. We're also doing another part of tomorrow's event. So we're giving out the free rune word. We're giving out a special boost. We're giving out a new artifact, the more cowbell artifact.
Right.
Oh my God, wait till you hear the sound effects.
Sound effects, great.
Oh my God, I freaked out. Our sound director was super excited for this one. We were like, hey, can you make us, never mind, I'm not going to spoil it. You have to see, it's pretty obvious, but you have to hear exactly what it is. And we're also upping, so we've been doing for the past week our Don't Fear the Reaper event, which I'll be sharing their schedule for, where we are live tuning.
Hence the cowbell.
Hence the cowbell. Exactly. Inside baseball. And so we've been live tuning the entire game, basically. We've been every three different game modes. Midtown is, I believe, right now, Terminals and X-Defense / Holosim for the bosses to have, like, a crazy loot explosion.
Yep.
Have you seen how ridiculous it is? I first saw it, I was like, oh, no. Like, this might be too far. And then we were like, ah, screw it.
Yep.
Actually, from my initial reaction of this might be too far, Doomsaw was like, we should make it more. Like, that doesn't seem like enough. Like, okay. Sounds good, Doomsaw. So we're upping our life.
Are you sure he was being serious and not facetious?
Well, that's for the Cosmic Cupcake to figure out.
It's hard to tell sometimes when he's pulling your leg or not.
As you could tell by the fact that he creepily sidled us and slow motioned out of the picture.
Exactly.
But yeah, so we're live tuning. We're still going to be doing Don't Fear the Reaper. We're still going to be rotating the live tuning schedule. But we're also doing right now a 50% boost to Rare Item Find, Special Item Find, and XP. We're going to be doubling that. We're going to double it. We're just going crazy. It's like Dave's super crazy Marvel
Dave
Heroes madness.
Dave has lost his damn mind.
And he's going to play with the community. Like, what is he doing?
I can't wait. I'm really looking forward to it. It's going to be fun. I mean, I'll be playing tonight as well, but on my secret account.
It's always funny, like, when I mention that I have another account, I feel like I must wonder, like, what do they think? Like, do they know that we're there with them? Like, there are so many times where I've seen people talking as if, obviously they don't know who I am. And it's like, man, if you guys knew. And sometimes I get really good feedback, and sometimes I get terribly insulted.
Yep.
No, I'm just kidding.
That's good, though.
They're generally, actually, we have a super awesome community. Like, I don't think I've ever had a bad experience playing with other players. Much as I like to pretend I do. Like, I like to tease them. Yeah, I play X Defense all the time, and like, I've never had a bad community experience in there. I play tons of terminals with people. I do everything, Holosim, and everybody's super nice and polite. And like, oh, sorry, I didn't do so good. It's like, why are our players so nice? Why are you guys so nice?
We have a really an extremely great community. It's pretty amazing.
It is pretty amazing.
I've been in other games where it's not quite as nice. That's for sure.
You definitely come from a long line of competitive, like super hardcore.
Absolutely.
Like, yeah, obviously, previous projects, it's got a pretty hardcore fan base, myself included. So,
all right, we're gonna answer some questions.
Let's talk about actual questions. I'm blabbing. I'm so sorry. Let's see.
It's fine.
That's a great question. Vaughn, I can't pronounce their name.
You don't need to.
Okay, guy with the V, man or woman with the V question. Asks, looking back to when you first started on this project, how far has the game exceeded your expectations as it stands today? That is a wonderful question. That is really well worded.
Well, the game, in a lot of ways, is very, very, very much like what I imagined it would be and hoped it would be. And so it's hard for me to tell. I mean, it has come such a far, compared to some of the first prototypes that we had of this game, it has come so far, it's unbelievable. But in a lot of ways, we're getting closer and closer to the game that I always dreamed it would be, kind of thing. And so we still have a bunch of things I still am excited about adding to the game. And, we have team-ups coming, and we have raids coming. We have all these kind of things that I really want to put in an action RPG in general. And so there's still a lot of growth and a lot of great stuff that we have in the future, some pretty crazy plans. But overall... you know, I'm really happy with where it is now, and it is I think playing very much like I want it to play at this point, where I'd hoped it would play all along.
I definitely see it. The game has come so far.
It has.
So fast. We have done so much crazy work, and man, like with raid, just seeing the raid stuff, I'm very excited for that. We're going to be talking about raids specifically at C2E2 next month.
Yeah.
Actually, I'm very excited. So if you guys are going to see, it's the Chicago Comic Con, C2E2, it's kind of an awesome name because it doesn't sound like a comic convention. If you guys are going to be there, make sure to check out our panel. We're going to be talking about raids and other future content. We have a lot of great stuff to spoil. And a little bit of just getting closer to Dave's dream, I think.
Like that's getting
like
there.
That's kind of like, that's almost what the subject of the panel is like, how can we get even closer to what Marvel Heroes should have always been and should always be and will be in the future? And team-ups, I wanted to talk about team-ups a little.
Okay.
So we couldn't show them off today for the reasons that stand withstanding, but I wanted to ask you about team-ups and what is your vision for team-ups? Like, what do you love about team-ups, the idea of team-ups?
New
inventory. We have 20 more slots.
Oh, that's so nice.
I'll see you in X Defense.
I didn't know that was going in today. I thought that was next time.
We snuck it in.
Oh, we didn't actually sneak
it in, but it's amazing. And also with team ups next week, those bad boys got 30 more item slots.
I know. That's great.
Everybody's going to be
so
inundated.
I mean, team ups is something that I mean, it's with higher bowls from Diablo 2. You know, that is something that I've enjoyed. You know, outfitting another character and doing all of the fun things that you can do with these characters, customizing them in some way.
Absolutely.
And stuff is just, I think it adds a lot of depth and it's just, it's a fun thing to have these extra inventory slots and be able to partner with somebody and have them come in and help you out and stuff. I think there's just a bunch of really fun things that we're going to be doing with them.
It's also very in the spirit of Marvel.
It is.
Like, the Marvel team-up is Marvel Comics.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like Marvel Comics in the 1960s really, like, expanded by being big. Like, by being a world that Daredevil can see the Fantastic Four.
Right.
And, like, we exemplify that by being a multiplayer game first and foremost. But this also lets you do that even if you don't play a lot of multiplayer. Speaking of Dupe, next week we have something pretty amazing. Have you seen Cosmic Dupe?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. People got a tease of him on the test. I got a fire rune? What? Oh man. This is not my live account. I got a fire rune and I can't have it. So this is obviously my dev account, so I don't get to keep this fire rune. And I'm very sad.
Trading.
I'm going to go meet myself in a room somewhere. Well, speaking of trading, yes, that is also something we have coming down the pipe.
Trading. We were just working this afternoon on what's going to go into the next release, and we're trying to squeeze it in soon. We'll see.
Cram it in there. It's fine.
Just trying to cram it in. Hopefully it'll be very, very soon.
I'm very, very excited for that. I can't wait for that. That is probably one of the number one features since launch, requested features. And we've been wanting to do it. We just wanted to make sure we got it, like, perfect.
Yep.
So on team-ups, obviously we're both big Marvel dorks. Who do you want to see as a team-up? What is your team-up?
Well, one of my classic and favorite team-ups is Cable and Deadpool.
Ah, of course. The bosom buddies of Marvel Comics.
So I would love to have that as and be running around.
I can't. I would love to hear that banter.
Yeah, me too.
With them just harassing and being terrible to each other and body sliding together and all that goodness.
How about you? What's your choice?
We talked about Kitty Pryde earlier, which is one of my tops, but I just pitched on to Doomsaw right outside before this. I would love to see Vision. I would love to play Scarlet Witch and
Witch and Vision. Yeah.
Yeah, that is my class. I know you're a big Scarlet Witch player.
I am.
And fan. So Vision is something about him would just be great. I think he really fits as a team up because he has a lot of powers that would be pretty hard to do for us. Like the density changing as far as he can also, like, same problem as Kitty Pryde.
Right.
He's like one of his big things that he goes through walls. And
right.
It's kind of like, well, isn't that just a not as fun version of teleport? Like, so that's a tough thing. But with a team up, we can do crazy things like have him come out of the ground and like fly up with a flying uppercut and like crazy stuff like that. So I would love to see somebody like that. And I'm gonna cheat and say too, I would love to see Captain Britain.
Captain Britain, okay.
I don't know why. I just love that.
Why not?
Guy. I love that guy. We're having his sister soon.
Oh really?
Psylocke, of course. Yeah, I'm very excited.
Oh yeah, that's
for her.
That's very soon, isn't
That's
it?
That's very, very soon. That is very, very soon. We're, you know, we're not going to give but it's very, very soon. I'm very excited for Psylocke.
Right.
That's a big request for us. She comes hot on the heels of, I think, right after Gambit, as far as, like, highest requested character in Marvel Heroes.
Really?
So I'm super excited to see her. Man, his VFX are ridiculous.
He looks so good.
I'm going to go buy the VFX team cheeseburgers.
Absolutely.
Just for this character. Let's go get cheeseburgers. So, yeah, team-ups. We addressed team-ups. We addressed our awesome Cow King weekend. Oh, my God, there's Dupe. I'm going to have to beat him up again. We don't kill him, though, because he's, you know, he's not a bad guy. We just really want what he has in his belly.
That's right.
People are getting very excited about Psylocke. Slapstick and Sleepwalker, somebody requested this team-up. That is the most awesomely 80s/90s request I've ever heard. I think Slapstick is also 90s. Those guys are ridiculous. That's a great request. Sleepwalker is one of those characters that is so just bizarre.
Let's get a question here.
Let's get another question. I'm sorry. I'm bad at this.
All right.
Oh, that's actually another fine, eloquent question.
Right.
Can you give us a vision, David Brevik, can you give us a vision of what max level play should look like in a year from now? What?
How about a couple months from now?
Oh, hey. Actually, let's just go there. Boom. Boom. Let's call it.
We're doing a whole bunch of things. We're adding a system. I don't know how much of this is announced and how much I'm going to get in trouble
anything.
For all of this. But we're going to be doing the we've got team-ups, which will be helpful. And then we're going to do it's our version of like an alternate advancement system, which we're, you know, what's the Diablo 3 one?
It's a Paragon.
Paragon.
And there's many MMOs have a legacy system or a so on and so forth.
Right, exactly.
But it's a pretty pretty straightforward concept as far as that goes, but we're going to do a pretty cool version.
Yeah, I'm very excited about it. And I think that that will add a lot to the end game. And then raiding is part of it. We've got PvP, and we're going to be adding some new modes for there. We're going to do... Oh, Jesus, can I even say some of the stuff? Competitive PvE. There's like a whole bunch of things that we have planned that are kind of coming in the future. And then we have some special. There are going to be several paths of things to do. You're going to have a raiding path. You're going to have a PvP path. You're going to have just looking for items path in different gameplay modes. We have a bunch of rune word things that we're going to be doing.
I'm very excited for that.
And so several months from now, the end game will be focused on playing some of these different modes and upgrading your equipment as well as advancing your character in alternate ways.
Several months. He asked for a year, and you gave him several months from now. And you gave him,
I know.
You gave him an insane answer for several months from now. What is it going to be like? It's like, oh, it's going to be crazy, sir.
Yes. When will we see achievements and legendary sharing? Wow, legendary sharing.
Legendary sharing is what? It's in iteration, I would
say. It is in iteration.
That is
a very good point of it. Very good way to put it. We've ran into some problems with it, and we are trying to fix them, and that's why it isn't out yet. Something that we all want, we all
play
the game and want that too, but there are some problems with it, and we're trying to fix them. So we have to fix a few other things before those will be ready, but I suspect they'll be ready fairly soon. And then achievements are coming.
I'm so excited.
Achievements are coming very soon.
Boom, achievements coming in 2014.
It's
2014.
There's a lot of engineering work that's going into achievements in the next release. They won't be visible yet, but achievements are coming very soon. We're actually working on a lot of the technology and stuff right now.
The missions team was just telling me that their time in the next few months is going to be spent heavily on achievements, which I'm very, very excited
for. So achievements are coming soon.
We have some pretty crazy ideas for those too, including some like very community-focused ones and events and all kinds of great stuff. So I'm super excited to see what we do with that. Let's get another question out.
Unannounced characters for 2014?
Unannounced characters for 2014.
Let's just say we have some.
We have some. We've got some. I'm gonna hold off on spoiling the advanced pack guys so far. We get a lot of questions about those guys. We're almost ready to spoil them. I would say we're...
Mac client is in... we're starting closed beta maybe as early as next week for Mac. So it is very, very close. We've been working on it a lot, and we've got our best engineers on and working nonstop, almost on the Mac stuff. So it'll be soon. We want Mac. I use a Mac, so I would really like it.
You have those awesome Marvel team affiliation stickers on your Mac.
I do.
Awesome. See, his Mac is even ready for it. It's got Marvel all over it.
Yes, it does.
What else do we got? We are getting a lot of great questions today.
I'm
very, very excited. People are excited that maybe they're tired of talking to stuffy old me, and they got David Brevik on the line.
Somebody's talking about my evil laugh, but you guys haven't even heard my evil laugh yet.
Have you laughed? I might have made you laugh a little.
Yeah, well, maybe, but I don't know if that's my evil laugh. My evil laugh is much more traditional.
I don't want to hear it. I'm very scared.
Yeah, no, it's scary.
I've heard it before, and it's very scary. It's very, very scary.
Okay, let's see what else we got here.
We got some good stuff.
Question, will we be able to play as Firestar and not just use her as a team-up character? That's a pretty good one. Team-ups do not mean that you won't be able to play that character in the future. This is why, one of the reasons why, Spider-Man's one of the team-ups is just because they're team-ups doesn't mean that they won't be available in the future. In fact, it makes it a little easier for them to be in the future rather than harder. So
yeah, definitely. It kind of gives us pillars of what we want to work with. It establishes their style visually. It gives us animations and a model already. It's a good jumping-off point.
Right.
It's a good jumping-off point. Let's see. Is there any new forms of leveling come in anytime in the future?
Is there any leveling coming up?
Or will there be a way to level a team up? So
team ups are at your level.
Right.
So there is no, maybe we would do some sort of thing in the future where it would be some alternate advancement for your team ups, but that's just an idea I just pulled out of the ether, and right now there are no plans.
Although, so if you guys, I don't think we've shared too much. Like Dave said, they do level with you, and you unlock more powers for them as you level.
Right.
Which is pretty cool, and you can customize them from there. So while like Dave said, we don't have a plan to currently let you level them themselves, but there's some bang for your buck out of leveling with your team up, and it makes it kind of a cohesive experience, which is pretty cool. I'm pretty excited to bring a team up to 1 to 20 with me.
Yeah.
Like, I almost want to save Doctor Strange to have a team up with him. I don't know who I would pick. I pick Magic because they're magical together.
Right.
And they just seems
makes,
right.
That's
that seems
a good
right.
Combo.
I think they
except for you could go. I mean, there you have a few different ways you could go. Actually, it depends on what your goal is, right? Do you want somebody to tank for you? Do you want magic combination? Do you want ranged attack? It's like that. There's lots of different combos. There's really no bad combo there.
That's true. I guess every team up is actually super useful, especially for Doctor Strange. I'm really excited for the ability to kind of just like make them your own. That was something that when we were designing team ups, there was a lot of internal discussion of like which direction to go with them, and I feel like we wound up in a really great place.
Yeah.
And that the iteration just got them to just be a really cool feature that I'm super excited for. It's going to be, I think, almost like a game changer in a lot of ways, because it's going to change the way you think about certain things.
Oh yeah,
and the way you think about playing your character and such.
You get to collect items for another character, and there's it's a lot of fun. You get to customize more, and then there's different combinations with the different heroes, and it's great.
Yeah, I'm very, very, very excited. What we have is an event for April Fool's Day, Like maybe we should do something in game. Like a fun April Fool's. We'll do minus 50% XP.
If you design it
I was kidding.
Wait, no, that's the April Fool's.
Oh.
If you design it this weekend, we'll do something for April Fool's.
You see that? There you go, guys. Maybe we'll do something for April Fool's. We've been so freaking busy, we haven't really had time to put too much work into an April Fool's joke this year. Because with team-ups, and we got
team-ups and the release today.
The good doctor here.
Exactly.
And then we got...
A lot of tie-ins with Captain America movie.
Of course, we got that new costume coming up.
And all the, and with Falcon as part
and
of
it. Plus the raid. The raid is taking
a lot of time.
But it's
and
good.
Then we're working on other fun features.
Other fun features, I would say. No, not too many spoilers.
All right.
Somebody said, for the love of God, Brevik, get that voice on the radio. I don't disagree
Thank you.
With that. I believe Doomsaw earlier said it's like something like it can melt chocolate from 20 yards. He said it in the chat. Question, when is Venom coming out? When are our villains coming out?
This year.
This year. Definitely this year. Absolutely. I think it's pretty safe to say.
We're not going to spoil it.
I think it's safe to say maybe a time frame, like a window. Like
are you going to give a window? I'm fine with you giving a window.
A small window?
I'll give you a large window.
He's going to get the large window. Give a large window.
Not in the next few months.
Boom. Large window.
But this year.
Who's your favorite villain from our lineup? Our three that we've announced.
Yeah, I guess Venom, probably.
Yeah, Venom's going to be so cool. Yeah. I almost cursed. I was so excited about Venom. I'm a huge Juggernaut fan. I don't know if you're aware of that. I don't know why. He's just my guy.
It's fine for him to be your guy.
I call him the Juggy Man. I even have a nickname for him for some reason.
I understand.
I think he's ridiculous.
My Colossus runs around in his... with that Juggernaut helm.
That is the coolest, one of the coolest costumes. That is my poser Juggernaut. Not really. He's pretty amazing looking. The metal really works. Let's see. What else do we got? Boop, 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 boop.
Let's see.
Will Thing ever get his spiky costume? Do you remember the John Byrne spiky thing? Where Thing had the giant crags coming out of his head?
Yeah.
I would love to do that.
Yeah.
That would actually be super bad or awesome looking.
Where's the sheet of paper? We're putting that
one down. Write this down. We're going to give that to Matt. Our producer, One-Armed Matt. He's been posting on the forums lately and introducing himself as our VO guy. That spiky thing is so good.
That's a good idea.
What about Carnage? Carnage is kind of a jerk. I don't know about putting Carnage in as playable. I think he'd be an awesome boss. What about you?
Evil team up.
Oh, there's evil laugh. No!
No, that was the start of the evil laugh.
If that was the evil laugh, I wouldn't be standing here. I would have had to leave. There's another Doctor Strange. How you doing, buddy? Fellow Sorcerer Supreme. So we're in the Jersey docks. You know, we like Jersey, but we like to tear it up sometimes. Any Stark Tech update? We recently talked about Stark Tech a bit on the forums. Stark Tech, we are... shifting Stark Tech as a design, but we are still planning to do the design we initially shared. It just might have a different name, so we're still planning on that. We'll have an update for that
in the
next couple weeks.
There will be new item types coming soon.
Oh, yes. New item types coming soon. See, he's so much better at making things concise. I just blabber on. you guys always want to know about release dates, and that is the one thing that we never like to share. Isn't that so?
I don't know. Doomsaw shares them all the
time. Hey, how has that gone traditionally?
Swell.
Smashingly. What is our most anticipated characters coming out in 2014? Mine's Juggernaut. I mean, I already answered mine. I am so excited for Juggernaut.
That's a good one.
What about you?
Star-Lord or Mr. Fantastic.
What? Who?
What?
Who?
Nobody.
Star-Lord. I love Star-Lord. Chris Pratt. I love that guy. I think he's great. He's going to have guns, and he's going to have friends. I don't know about
great.
It in his
did
power.
Did I just spoil something?
No.
All right, good.
Yes, you did. It's okay. He's going to be...
I don't know what we've announced and haven't announced.
No, I think they know. We have. That's not a super spoiler. I was just being a jerk. She-Hulk. She-Hulk is both an awesome... Would be an awesome playable and an awesome team-up because she teams up with lots of people.
She would be great.
A red She-Hulk would also be awesome. You could have the matching costume for Defenders. Doctor Strange here, who I'm going to play as now.
Oh, nice.
I prepared. You know, I came prepared.
Yeah, you did.
Our team-ups available through Eternity Splitters? You betcha. Doomsaw recently posted an FAQ, which has the prices and gives a little bit of more detail, but you can definitely get them for Eternity Splitters. We think that's a super important part of them. Somebody just asked me in-game if they'll be allowed in PvP. The answer is yes, because we think that as a feature, they are compelling enough to be allowed anywhere, and we want to see where people take that.
Yep.
Like, I want to see how people utilize them in PvP. So we're very excited to see what people do with that and PvP and raids and pretty much anything.
Yep.
That's all part of the plan. What else? What do we got? Can I be Pyro with a team up of the Blob? You answer that, Dave. What do you think?
I'm sorry, I was reading a question. I didn't hear what you said.
Actually, answer your question. What question?
I was just reading. Somebody was asking when Nova is coming.
When is Nova? Nova is coming this year as well.
Yeah.
That is the. You can give a Dave Brevik window of time, we're going to call that from now on. Which sounds like
not in the next few months, but
it sounds like a book. He's coming up, though. He's coming up. Pretty quick, I would say, but not like Dave said. I think in between our answers is the truth.
He's on the shorter list.
Yes. The not insanely long, we want to do every Marvel character in the game list, but the this year list. Momentum mechanic. Ah, he's teasing. We had mentioned before that we were thinking about a momentum mechanic for Juggernaut. Still in the design phase, so he's a bit of ways away.
Oh, yeah.
So he builds it up as he gets going.
Yeah, yeah.
There's a lot of cool things you could do with that.
Yep.
Doomsaw is, I think, answering questions for us. He's stealing all the good ones.
Doomsaw,
he's in chat. So if you guys have questions, you can also ask him. But you should probably ask Dave because he's super busy and he's not going to hang around listening to me yammer on about how much I love the Juggernaut for too much longer.
Well, I'll give you another couple minutes.
I love yammering. That is an awesome idea. Can medkits be changed to shawarma? Call Cosmic Cupcake. We just had a great idea. Heroes don't use medkits. They just get hungry.
I can't see why not.
At least for Wolverine. That guy is always eating.
Yeah, absolutely.
That's a pretty great idea, actually. Maybe an alternate medkit, like Artifact. Like you slot an Artifact as an alternate medkit of shawarma. Any update on Gambit?
Now Doomsaw's, his feelers are hurt.
Oh, I'm kidding, Doomsaw. I'm just giving you a hard time because you're stealing all of our questions, man. Is there a chance for Blade to be released this year? Not this year, but probably not. But I would love to do Blade. Oh, my God. Yeah. Blade, I think Dave shares my excitement of Blade. I don't know why. I don't know why I love Blade so much, but I think he's freaking awesome.
He is awesome.
The glaive, like spinning. That'd be so good.
Good stuff.
I'm geeking out again. Every time I hang out with Dave, I just end up geeking out at him. And then he walks away awkwardly. And I'm like, who's that guy? Whoa. Did we hire that guy? He's always just talking about
not comics. At all.
tacos for Deadpool. See, everybody could just have their own form of unique medkit.
Their own.
Wolverine would be a bowl of cereal because he just eats cereal a lot. And he's a man after my own heart. I see what Doomsaw did. Reverse psychology 101. He was tired of answering questions. I don't believe that for a second.
That is not true at all.
So
he is.
He loves
nothing better than answering questions.
What is the most exciting thing that we've added to our game in the past 3 months for you? What do you love the most that we've already added? It could be today. It could be our 20 slots of inventory.
Well, that's right up there.
It's pretty far up there. I know that seems minor. If you're not super familiar, that is
quality of life change.
I totally agree.
Favorite thing in the last, probably rune words.
I agree. That is my favorite. I just got excited, like, oh my God, a fire rune. Like, I wish I could have this. I did a phone call with somebody who was, like, asking questions during an interview a month or two ago about the game. And we were playing X Defense together. And I was like, yeah, like, I'll show you some stuff, like, because it was an interview. And I was like, let's just play. And I found a Sif rune. And it was on this account, and I got so mad, and I was so excited at the same time. I was like, oh my gosh, I've been looking for this rune forever. But yeah, so what do you...
That's something that happens to me, you know, like I said, when I'm demoing the game to people or whatever, I also get very excited, like, oh my God, this dropped or whatever, and in the middle of some demo,
exactly.
I'm supposed to act all professional, oh my God, it's a cosmic!
I'm like, oh, sorry,
don't understand what just happened here.
I really like that unique, and I really wanted that. Please ignore. But what do you love about rune words other than the fact that they're rune words, which are awesome, and obviously you have some experience with?
I do.
I hear. Somebody told me.
I love the crafting element of the entire thing. I like collecting things and putting them together and being able to craft what you want and, you know, being able to... I like that whole gameplay. There's still some randomness associated with there's Duper.
Oh.
And as well as being able to... I just like the crafting element of the game the most. That's something I like in a lot of other games as well as MMOs, and it's something I spend a lot of time doing.
I love crafting. Anytime we improve our crafting... Speaking of which, have you seen the new crafting UI, by the way? We made an update to make it much more sexy and smooth.
In this build?
In this build. See, we're surprising David Brevik slipping things in that he didn't even realize. We updated the crafting UI. I love crafting.
I've
totally agree.
I've been away on the, you know, I had tons of meetings at GDC, and I was at some other conference before that. And
so it's like
I've been out of the week office for about 2 weeks now.
I think something that's funny about our game is that I look back and I think about what wasn't there even as early as like 3 months ago. I'm like, that wasn't in our game.
I know.
Like, I'm so used to that now.
Yeah, yeah.
Because our game changes. We iterate and we change our game so rapidly. And it's just a, I don't know. Like, I would love to see it from the other side. Like, how exciting it must be for a player that isn't here every day kind of thing. You know what I mean? Like, because no other, I've never played a game that updates like we do.
Changes
like we do.
I really feel like we update and add more content to our game than almost maybe any other game that I know of.
Anyone that I'm personally aware of, like, and
our
development
team is really incredible.
The amount of things they get done in a single month or in even 2 months is absolutely ludicrous and is unseen in this industry, and it's very exciting. Both as a player who has spent 1,000 hours playing our game, and as somebody who works here, it says, man, these VFX are so good. I just want to look at fire.
All right. Couple more questions.
Let's do some more questions. I'm sorry.
Actually do some more.
He's got this taken away from all the business. All the business stuff.
Well, maybe I won't get back to work, actually.
He's just going to go play. Dave's just going to we'll just play X Defense, and it's fine. Now he's got all that room for runes. So what do we got going on here? Can you spoil any? See, he's asking a Doomsaw. We're going to steal from Doomsaw and hope he doesn't answer first. What kind of new enemies are going to fight this year? We got the Bronx Zoo. We talked a little bit about that. Let's talk. Who are we going to fight in the Bronx Zoo?
Are we giving that away?
Let's tease one. I think we can tease one. Pick your favorite of the two.
Oh, Lizard.
Lizard, of course. I love Lizard. I love it. So we're going to be adding. We're definitely adding new villains. The raid obviously has a new villain.
Yeah.
And Oh man.
As well as others.
But the Lizard, we're going to be adding a new piece of content later this year that we've teased a handful of times.
Yeah.
And people are kind of like, it's one of those things that, like Stark Tech, it's kind of like waiting in the wings.
It has been. But, well, yeah.
But I'm very excited for that piece of content. The Lizard is going to be awesome. I think he's one of the coolest Spider-Man villains. One of the coolest. Spider-Man just has the best villains.
He has great villains.
He just has some of the best. And so, yeah, the Lizard, we're going to be adding the Lizard and many more this year. And I'm excited for you guys to see more, but we don't want to spoil everything. That would be really rude. Cow King team up coming. Whoa. That would be really... Can I have a Brevik team up? Are people aware of what the... I wonder if you guys know about the model for the Cow King.
Who? If the community knows.
Because it's one of those things that it's very subtle. But he has a pretty spectacular pair of frames. That's all I'm going to say.
He does.
He's got some nice specs.
We're not going to say who it's modeled after.
No.
It's for the public to find out.
Some male model, probably. I think I just doomsawed that. Can we get Mephisto in the game? Well, Spider-Man isn't married in our game, so he technically already is. That was a low blow. Sorry, ooh, Spider-Man fans. That was a One More Day reference. Actually, I don't know if Spider-Man's married in our game. We don't really establish that.
Yeah.
What else do we got? Brevik, the godlike team up. I totally agree. Blade is a team up. That would be cool. I would team up with Blade.
That would be great. Yeah.
So he could be playable and team up, just like he wants Cable and Deadpool. I would say Deadpool would be the team up of those two. What do you say?
Yeah, I mean, Cable and Deadpool, that's what I can do. I'm looking forward to that one.
I foresee Deadpool annoying every character on a roster as being a great idea. He already does.
When is Silver Surfer coming out?
Dave, take it. We're in a band now.
Not this year, unfortunately.
But he is coming, and he's going to be amazing. We have some crazy cool ideas for him. That is one of my most anticipated as well. What about you?
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
He's going to change things a lot. One of our engineers recently...
I mean, the beauty is that we're in this for the long haul here, where, you know, this is, we have a lot of time. We're going to get to, you know, a lot of the great characters. We're going to be doing this for a long time. So,
Stay a while and listen. We got some good stuff coming. Can we get a playable Sabretooth? Let's see what else do we got. Will this game ever have a native Mac OS client? We're definitely coming to Mac very, very soon, as Dave was talking about earlier. Silver Surfer, no. He's still coming. I'm sorry. He's going to be amazing.
That's the biggest D3 ripoff.
That's
hilarious.
That's good.
David, are you in investor of Marvel Heroes.
David is the creator of Marvel Heroes. And some other games, you know, Diablo and Diablo 2. Those games, those pretty good games. I'm just kidding. I'm being a jerk now. I'm turning into a jerk. I'm being a jerky live streamer. I know, I died. Everybody's making fun of me because I died. Dave, why'd you let me die? Dave, please. Why?
You know,
it's
the way it goes.
You made it so that I die?
Yeah, absolutely.
Dave designed this game.
Unplugged your mouse. How's that? That's a good story.
That's a good story. Yep.
We'll go with that.
It wasn't user error. It was Dave Brevik's evil laughter. it's coming.
No, that wasn't it.
Oh. So
I'm bringing it back. I'm going to keep it contained here.
Let's do two more things. Let's talk about two more things, and then you have to go. Doomsaw is taunting me even. Two more things.
Sure.
One. I don't know. I wanted you to have something really great.
This is the worst setup of all time.
Yeah, I failed. But it's funny for everybody to watch me fail. dang.
All right.
So let's talk about something. The best thing we could possibly talk about in Marvel Heroes. Let's talk about something really big picture.
Big picture.
Big picture.
All right.
Let's talk about
the far future.
The far future. Let's go.
Oh, you want me to talk
about... I'm just kidding. I'm totally just setting it up to be a jerk. So Marvel Heroes, everybody's... Obviously, we've changed tons. We're adding all these... We've just spoiled a ton of features and a ton of new content coming out. Do we have new story content coming? We get questions about that all the time. You don't have to spoil it. Please don't spoil what it is. We won't spoil
it. I'm not going to spoil what it is, but of course we're going to have new story content.
Of course. We get that question all the time. That's one of the biggest questions that people always... I'm sure you get that asked every Play with the Devs weekend. Like, when's the story content coming? Obviously, we have a ton of new heroes coming out. We accidentally, we spoil them all the time. We love to tease you guys. Invisible Woman is coming out next month.
Yes, yeah, she's next.
She is so cool. She is very...
Her design's great.
She's actually on screen right now. You can't see her. the first team up, ironically. She's every proc effect in the game is actually just her. But yeah, I'm very, very excited for that. PvP.
Yeah.
Coming out of beta pretty soon, our first mode.
Yep.
We have a lot of things coming along with that. What are your feelings of PvP in general? People ask that a lot. They always ask, like, what does Dave feel about PvP?
I love PvP. We're still working on our PvP, and we're going to continue to work on it, and then we're going to put in some other PvP modes and things like that. Other maps or modes or whatever you want to call them. PvP is an important part of the game. I love that. There's all sorts of things we can do, especially PvP, once, playable villains are a bigger part of the game. There's all sorts of really fun things we can do there. So a lot of great stuff coming for PvP in the next year.
One of my favorite requests for PvP is, people ask me, is that they, I don't know if you've ever heard this as well, they always ask if devs could be able to play as villains and beat them up. Wouldn't that be awesome? Like, you get to Cosmic Doctor Doom, and it's Dave Brevik, and this sounds fun. He's bored that day, and he destroys you. I don't foresee that coming anytime soon, but I always think it's an amazing idea. But yeah, PvP is a huge question for us. It's a huge mode for us. Super excited for more of that to come out. What is the last question I want to ask David freaking Brevik on a live stream? And I'm choking.
It's all right.
It's okay. This is dual spec. We're definitely talking about dual spec.
Yeah, that's dual specs coming.
Oh, yeah. We definitely want to do that. Player housing, probably further out, but it would be really awesome. Probably pretty far out, because we have so many new gameplay modes that we're adding just in this year alone that I don't foresee us stopping on the gameplay mode
to go
path to move towards sandbox mode. But
it's
always possible. Guild leveling, that is a great feature, actually. Supergroup features, I know you're super passionate about this as well.
Yeah.
This is a huge deal for you. So what kind of plans would you like to see Marvel Hero have in a year? What do you think our supergroup system might look like? We're not promising.
Yeah, no, I mean, we would like to do guild achievements and guild leveling and like a whole bunch of things like that will make the guilds have a richer, deeper experience. We also have... I'm not going to spoil a whole bunch of things here, but we have some pretty crazy plans for... I'm not even going to say it. But we have some really neat things that we're going to do with guilds that I don't know that any other game that's doing.
Boom. That is the best tease ever. Anytime you see, I don't know if anybody else has ever done this, and you blow everyone's minds, and now they're going to be scratching at your actual door.
Yeah.
Because I don't even, I need to know. No, I'm just kidding.
I don't even know how many of the team members know it. So.
Well, I need to, we're going to have a meeting after this to make sure that I know, because I'm so jealous. But yeah, so I think that is something that we people feel that we haven't touched on in long enough. We actually just added Last On Live. I don't have a guild on my dev account, so I can't show you. We have Last On Live now and Message of the Day, which I'm
message
super excited
of the day
for.
Went in this time.
So we wanted to do, you know, those are just two small quality of life improvements to build a more fruitful guild system. And so I'm trying to think.
They're getting a good tune-up before raiding.
I feel like the reason I'm having had such a hard time asking questions is because even though we've been goofing around, we've touched on so many major pillars of the game. Like, we've touched on itemization, PvP, raid content, team-ups, guilds, story content, upcoming characters. What else?
We not very much, then.
No, we have some we have some other things. Let's see if we have one last.
All right, one last one. Here we go.
Ladders and hardcore. That is a very Dave Brevik question.
Ladders.
Ladders and hardcore. Oh, how does Dave Brevik like ladders and hardcore?
I love ladders.
I would love.
Yeah. Yes, that's on the short list. So it's coming soon.
Short list for us though, miles long, literally miles.
Oh yeah. No, but ladders are in the definite plan in a soon-ish time frame. It is going to be they are an
excited.
Important thing that we are going to put in.
You heard it from the man himself. We all have a pretty awesome set of features coming out just this year alone. And like the talks of next year are already crazy. Are already blowing my mind. It's like, imagine what we could do next year.
Yeah.
We pack everything into this year, and every month we have amazing stuff. Dave, I don't think there is a week that go by that I don't hear about like 10 awesome plans that Dave has. Like 10 is probably like undershooting it, but even just for like a weekly event, like Dave.
I'm stealing them all from Doomsaw.
Well, don't we all? He steals them all from me, but he'll never tell you.
You owe me a dollar later, Doomsaw.
Oh. but yeah, so I think we basically hit on the entire game. Not really.
Pretty much.
We hit on pretty much everything there is to know. And why isn't Silver Surfer coming out this year? Because we have some really cool plans for him and the way he might want to work, because he's pretty different. And I'll answer that. We want to do him right.
Yeah.
I think that's fair.
Absolutely.
I think that's the way to say it. That's why he kind of got pushed in favor of some other, not in favor of characters, but just so that we were absolutely sure we could schedule him properly.
Yeah.
So let's wrap this up. People are talking in chat about the things that we've spoiled on the stream, which is pretty amazing. I see people talking about what you spoiled earlier, and that's awesome. About a certain stretchy man. Are we going to C2E2? Yes, we will both
be
at C2E2.
I'll be there.
And Doomsaw will be there, and Matt Group, aka One Arm Matt, our VO and story producer, will be there, and we are going to be blowing your minds with some super awesome secrets.
I can't believe that you just left Duke behind.
I did, because I wanted my friend the Thing to kill him. Oh, I love the Thing. Somebody had an idea for the Thing the other day that made me so excited, and I want to spoil it, so I forced Doomsaw to do it.
I know what it is.
With the telephone pole or the lamppost swing.
Yeah.
How awesome! So Thing rework 2014. I promise it'll be awesome, because I'm very excited for the Thing rework and the Wolverine one as well. Thank you for streaming with us. Thank you for joining us.
Oh, weekend events.
Oh, let's wrap that up. Let's wrap up with some. Actually, do you have 2 minutes to spoil something? One more thing.
All right.
One more thing.
I'm
sorry.
No, it's okay.
Sorry. We're going to spoil. We have a new costume to show off with a team up. So we talked about it earlier. We have Captain America with the Winter Soldier, this little film that's coming out next week.
Right.
And we have a costume coming out next week that is somewhat related to Captain America with the Winter Soldier.
Oh.
So we got this marketing pulled together and this awesome pose and everything for us with the art from the art team. And so we got next week, we got Falcon team up and Captain America in his Winter Soldier costume. And I am super duper excited for that.
Yeah.
I am. It looks so good. So we have Cap there, and then so let's talk about this weekend a little bit. So this weekend we got more Cowbell Saturday.
Nice.
Which is play with David Brevik, get tons of free stuff just for logging in that day. So you get a Cosmic Cow King crate, which has a Cosmic Pentadeus boost, Portal of Bovenheim, Portal of Confidential Bovine Sector. Bovine is a really funny word to say. The random level 60 Cosmic Medallion.
That's crazy.
I'm super excited for that. There's so many I want. Gotta get Tombstone. New rare artifact called Brevik's Cowbell.
It's so fun.
Oh, so good. And the Cow King's Gift, a new rune word. We're not going to spoil what that does right now, but it's pretty great. And then last and definitely not least, we have this little magical ongoing event, the Don't Fear the Reaper event, that we have been live tuning every 4 to 6 hours, depending on the time block. And so we're live tuning X Defense, and Hollow Sim, Midtown, and Terminals to have crazy loot explosions that are kind of ridiculous, but net some pretty insane loot. And in addition, on Saturday, we're going to be doubling our live tuning percentage to 100%. So it's going to be definitely overdone, but it'll be funny. It's totally worth it for our players.
It'll be great.
Oh, and there's this.
And I'm playing tomorrow.
This code. Yeah, you're playing. Yeah, he's playing. Dave's playing for 4 hours.
My account's Xerix.
1 to 4 p.m. He's going to be on Xerix, which is X-A-R-E-X. Mm-hmm. And you can find that on the forums and general announcements. We have the More Cowbell Saturday information. You can find out when to play with Dave, how to harass him the best, what his favorite thing to eat is. I don't know that answer, actually. But we also have today...
Probably tacos.
Tacos are good. Let's go get some tacos. today we have this gift code that you can enter right here. Right in front of Dave.
Oh, yeah.
You enter that code on your MarvelHeroes.com profile, and you will get a free hero and some boosts. So you get a free introduction. We are doing way too many things.
I can't believe we've done all this. We may have gone a little nuts.
I just realized, as I'm saying this, I'm like, I forgot this because we're doing so many things. You'll get a free introductory 200 Splinter Hero, which can be Hawkeye, Scarlet Witch, Storm, Daredevil, Thing, or Black Widow. And you get a nice spread of boosts. And that'll, if you're playing Doctor Strange this weekend, that'll be nice. It's a random hero of that group, so maybe somebody you already have, in which case you'll get an ultimate token. But it's totally free, so why not try? Why not try? So... thank you very much for joining us, Dave.
My pleasure.
This has been fun. I have had a great time kind of annoying the crap out of, no, I'm just kidding, teasing you about various things.
And
but
only
also,
dying a couple times.
And only dying maybe once.
Once.
And also answering a bunch of, maybe more. see, you can tease me back. Thank you so much for answering the community's questions. This is a huge part of what we do here is interact with you guys. And my job is obviously, as a community manager, to interact with you guys. And I love it. Like, you guys are, this has been a blast. And I love being able to do these streams and answer questions, especially when I get Dave on. maybe soon I'll get Doomsaw.
Maybe.
And then I'll make him cry. Do you think we can make Doomsaw cry on a live stream?
Oh, I'm sure.
Oh, that would be so good. We're not going to make Doomsaw cry, but maybe. I hope he's still watching so that he just hears that we're going to be really mean to him and bully him like schoolyard children. All right, well, I'm going to let you go because I know I've heard your phone ringing for the past 10 minutes.
Yeah, it has.
Of like, oh my gosh, right. Where's Dave? We have all these meetings. We're planning all these things, and we don't have Dave. So thank you very much for joining us, Dave. I don't know what time it is, so I don't know if I should just keep going.
Let's see.
Oh, it is. It is past. It is about time. Past our time. 5:15.
So
thank you very much for joining us this week, guys. Like I said, we'll have a live stream early, hopefully mid to early next week, to show off team ups. So I'm going to have Michael May, who's been designing them, showing off the UI, and we're going to talk about all their powers and stuff. So we'll see you then. Make sure to follow, and have a great one. We're gonna.